Pitsimana humana isola sangulabo. Ya Aziza, Aziza, Aziza.
What are you to run one? I talk to me, Takutigala, Narambia.
Sahet, Sahet, Tanong
Malilakin Nagilo, Malisizaki, Lazaro Zaksta. Lakin Nandula, you are to not
sit out at sea, Pitik Palum.
Did you do one milk, King on me, Alakartausima, Zagagia Hani? Kadisigia Halarit.
My name is Jimmy Manning. I'm from Cape Dorset, and I've lived here all my life, but I was born in Lake Harbour, now called Kenojuak. Before art, a lot of early people were always practicing how to make tools. Their intention was to survive on the land. With Jim Houston coming here in Cape Dorset, he was very interested in sculpture and also producing prints, which was really, really something different for our very small community. There was Izibaluk, Luktak, Aiola, Kanangina Putugu, Kenojuak Ashivak. Very fast learners when it comes to, you know, carving on serpentine, making the images, and then transferring and inking up. You had artists that sell to the co-op, and then you had people already in the shops and in Wabik, who were able to work for the arts. Now people down south are interested in our work.
Initially, everyone was astonished at this extraordinary talent that suddenly was found in the Canadian North that people hadn't understood was there. And the talent ranged from the astonishing innovation of an artist such as Kenojuak Ashivak. She came out fully with her own graphic design and made fully resolved, beautiful compositions that bore no resemblance to anything southern, northern, western that anyone had ever seen. These were not derivative stories. These were stories that these people had lived. This was their life.
Economically, it was very helpful for these artists because the money was able to come into Cape Dorset, and then they were able to buy for the families.
My late aunt, Kenojuak, she inspired me a lot. The artists before me, I have the privilege to see their work outside of Dorset, meaning down south in museums and galleries. And I am amazed how this whole thing started.
Well, that's the amazing thing. You go to this print shop that was built in the 1950s. I mean, this is the wellspring where it all started. And it struck me when I was there as a Canadian that this was a facility that our country needed to modernize, to build and to make sure that we have working space for artists of the current generation.
The community have long wanted to see a new building, not just to use as a studio, because Cape Dorset is known to have a very good collection in art and artifacts that came from around this area.
The first section we have was built back in 1957, 58, around there.
It's very obvious how old they are and how they were just sort of pieced together, and the work environments is not the greatest for the printmakers.
And the new prints are going to be much better for the fire coat hazard. They're going to be much better for us, and also better equipment and better ventilated system.
from that perspective, we have looked at their current installations and made sure that the new installations cover and protect them from all these risks. And really, they'll have a state-of-the-art facility. The building will be welcoming, will be warm, will be a place where both artists and the public will want to come, because it is a place where it's fun to work in, it's a good place to work in, and it's a good place to meet. The community picked this location more than 40 years ago, so it's very centrally located at the heart of the hamlet.
The cultural center part is very, very important to have and long overdue, because there's so many people that has come through here from the south, from Europe, from Japan, from all over the world, very interested in seeing the art.
Good afternoon, everyone.
When we get tourists, our studios can only take so much people, and all they want to see is going to the co-op and see the art. And then people can't go all in there all at once. People have to line outside.
The cultural side, or the cultural function of this facility, they see it as a haggik. What was a haggik traditionally? It was a meeting place, a large communal igloo where elders, youth, everybody in the community would actually meet, tell stories, share traditional knowledge, talk about the future, you name it.
You tell stories of what you experienced out on the land. It's never too late to teach a kid or a teenager to learn the cultures we know about the land. And hopefully someday they'll translate that story into paper too.
Once I went up to my sister's guta, she picked up her paper and her pen. Why don't you start drawing here, and then if you finish it, go down to Jimmy. He started liking it instantly.
It's incredibly moving as a Canadian. I went there about 7 years ago as a government minister. There's something I have to do that's unattended business, and it's to make sure that the cultural center there is built, that it's modernized, that we have working space for Inuit artists, and that we celebrate all the great artistic achievements that have happened in Dorset over many years.
This is something that will certainly be trailblazing or groundbreaking for Nunavut in general. This whole notion of we've got lots of data, we've got archaeological artifacts, we've got all of these things, what do we do with them? How can we give them meaning such that the youth and others from the community can really have this dialogue with, in some ways, their history, their culture, and their ancestors?
My hopes are always high to the kids after me will hopefully, like me, start drawing and be known worldwide.
I'm proud that my father and his mother and his relatives, whatnot, back then started this co-op. And that was a pride to opening up a cultural center would be an idea for the community. And it would be a pride for the community.
And this whole program with the new print shop and cultural center is just going to be the icing on the cake of where we want to bring it to for the next level.
Just last week at Papier, there was a review of my booth by a reviewer from the Canadian Art Magazine, which said that the finest drawing in Canada is coming out of the Cape Dorset cooperative.
I'm really proud to be part of this because I'm part of the printmaking here in Dorset. So I'll be part of the collection because I'm the one who's making prints. I'm always satisfied to work with the odd R's.
You can love me humpback whales, second last, the last day of the year.
You call her humpback.
Really good.
This will be a great privilege to show the people outside the true meaning of Cape Dorset and art that's well known worldwide, and this is the best place to express Cape Dorset is through the Culture Center.
We should all support the Kenojuak Cultural Center, the print shop in Dorset, because if you're passionate about Canada, if you're passionate about the arts, and if you're passionate about Inuit people, this is the project. It is, I believe, one of the most important cultural projects in the country, and it deserves the support of all of us.
Ila manapirum nang ninga Inuit, hanwigum nang ninga sanagum nang ninga tana pimmagiu simamman.
Pitik simane hongwana isulla sangulla bo iya.
There's really no word in Inuktitut for art, but they have to do something to create, making sculptures, carving outside their tent, and singing at the same time. It's a special way of being happy, so it has been very important for my heart to be able to connect with my people here, people from Dorset. We're all together like a big family.
Atawa pitita o atapareta o niut twatia kut twatia me kudwaltiga una.